Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. We're here today again with Dr. Kishan. And we're going to be talking about hair loss, both for men and women. Talking about myself first of all, because everybody likes doing that, they like talking about themselves. I have always had quite thin hair, which is tragic. So for the past, I think, God, like 10 years, I've always worn extensions, which is probably why.
Quite damaging.
Well, I don't know what, it hasn't actually changed that much. Cool. I think it depends on who you go to and how much they pull your hair they're taking them out. Anyway, so I've always had extensions, and that's probably why you've noticed like my hair going up and down, changing, doing various different things with the color, etc., which is fun. But I have recently started using a cream which contains various different hormones, etc., to try to help me grow my hair. It's not been long enough for me to tell you like how effective or not it's been, but why don't you tell us a little bit about what you would do for women?
Sure. You can have general hair thinning, you know, hair loss. You know, people talk about telogen effluvium, where the hair cycle comes to the end of its growing phase and then enters into a sort of a resting phase and then falls out, and that falling out phase is the telogen phase, or the hair is actually just stuck there and basically it's dead and it needs to be shed before the next new hair can come through. So often people will come to me and they'll say, I see a lot of hair fall, and essentially it's just that the hair is going through the cycle. Now that can be triggered by certain things like poor nutrition or periods of stress. So that's one entity, of hair loss. We've got people who've genetically just got thin hair. I mean, suppose like you've mentioned for yourself. As people get older, we've got some other conditions, some autoimmune conditions like alopecia areata. We've also got androgenic alopecia as well. We've got levels of testosterone that are being converted to dihydrotestosterone, which is then acting on the hair in the scalp, and the hair is basically being turned into a vellus, going from a sort of a normal, healthy shaft to a thin, very fine textured hair, which is barely visible. So that very soft hair gives the appearance of thinning scalp.
And I have that all over my face, which is a separate subject, I think. So, enough about that. What are you going to do for me?
Right, so essentially you've got this amazing cream, which is a combination of hormones. So we've got the hormones that not just compete, but they improve the health of the hair through attaching to receptors in the scalp skin. So these will be estrogen and progesterone. Pharmaceutical treatments like spironolactone, like minoxidil, and even melatonin, which is another important hormone to help with the hair growth. So minoxidil and spironolactone are very, very well known anti-hair fall treatments, which people do take by mouth, but essentially I find them a lot safer if you apply them directly to the scalp, and there's also much less systemic absorption. In one hit, you're with a topical cream containing hormones and pharmaceutically active agents, you're not only treating the scalp directly, but you're also avoiding the systemic effect of the drugs and the hormones, and avoiding that interference with the liver. Largely, when we're doing hormones, we tend to prescribe pharmaceutical, branded, licensed products, and I think that's always better if we have that as an option for our patients. However, I have got some patients who've got allergies to certain ingredients, such as sodium lauryl sulfate. I've got patients who can't take the standard doses of medications that are available through the pharmacies. So sometimes we will custom make a treatment for a patient, and particularly for hair treatments, are much more effective because, for example, they'll have much more than one ingredient like minoxidil. So you can buy Regain, which is minoxidil foam, and that's usually 2% or 5%. It's very, very easy to find. But I find that on its own, it doesn't necessarily have the same benefits as when you combine it with other ingredients like spironolactone, like Latanoprost, which give much longer lasting and much more effective regeneration of the hair growth.
And those ingredients that you just spoke about there, would they be mainly for men or women?
For a female, I usually use estrogen, progesterone. I'll use spironolactone if the patient doesn't want to have children, and also Latanoprost as well. Melatonin's great, particularly if you are having issues with sleep, because you do get some low level absorption of that.
That must be why my hair's tired. Moving on to men then.
So I see a lot of men specifically for this problem, for male pattern hair loss, and it is quite an issue because it can start even as young as as a man in his 20s, and there's obviously a genetic component to it as well. For men, I think these compounded treatments are so effective. They can be so effective, especially combined with treatments like PRP, which we do at the clinic as well. But if a gentleman's using a product like this every day, it enhances the results so much more. That's what I've seen. So anecdotally, I find that these compounded preparations are really effective. And the other thing is that I can use treatments which by mouth have got recognized side effects. But topically, because the systemic absorption is so low, we don't seem to see those side effects.
Mm. So specifically, what are you doing differently for men?
So for men, I tend to avoid hormones in the first instance. So I won't necessarily put in progesterone or estrogen or anything like that. Or if I do, I might put a very, very, very low level. What I generally use for men is a topical form of finasteride or dutasteride, which is the other version of a 5-alpha reductase blocker. I will also use minoxidil, which you can find in Regain, and it's very effective, but it's even more effective when used synergistically with our compounded blend. And also I will use latanoprost. Now latanoprost was found accidentally,
happy coincidence.
Happy coincidentally, exactly. To thicken the growth of eyelashes when patients would use drops in their eyes. And actually this product in a topical hair formulation works really well.
Are you using foam, cream, a tincture?
Both. Mm-hmm. So some patients will like the texture of a tonic and some patients prefer a foam. I find the cream doesn't suit everyone because it's quite it can be quite tacky. Mm. So I think a lot of people prefer the foam actually. Mm. It just depends. It's horses for courses.
I quite like that word, teacher. Mm. It reminds me like of Final Fantasy VII or something.
Like an apothecary's made it, especially for you.
Yeah, I love
which
it.
Is exactly what this is really.
There's something quite exciting in the pipeline as well.
So PRP is a very, very good, well-recognized injectable treatment that we do for hair regeneration. However, we can also use a 5-alpha reductase blocker, which is diluted in saline and then injected in very, very small doses in the areas of hair loss. And that's a very, very effective treatment. So we're just waiting on the final regulation surrounding that before we can offer that as a treatment.
It's a pipeline.
It's going to be very exciting because it's something that only needs to be done every 2 months. And the results from that have been phenomenal in the research.
So can you talk a little bit about any testing that you're doing?
Okay, so I don't strictly need testing before we start recommending a hair loss treatment. However, it's obviously that's the ideal, and we'd want to look at vitamin deficiencies and vitamin mineral deficiencies. And there are ways that we can test for that, as usually is done as part of our hormonal general testing. The other thing I was going to suggest is that patients sort of have a think about their nutrition in general. So you need to have healthy fats, a good balance of omega-3s and 6s, make sure you're taking a B complex. Biotin is a very, very, very good vitamin for hair loss. So it's basically a B vitamin, B7, zinc, selenium, whole foods based diet.
So I've been having the biotin injections into the butt for like 3 weeks.
You're a trooper.
I know, I like to try these things. I don't know if it's had any effect yet. We shall see. Mm.
So like I was going to say, I think if we're going to be recommending vitamin interventions, a good thing to do is to actually try to test for them first.
Mm. Which I did, by the way. Okay guys, so that's it for this week. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thyroid is another reason why people lose their hair.
Exactly. And so we were going to talk about it in this one, but actually that's a nice segue into the next topic, isn't it, really, about thyroid health.
Okay guys, so that's it. We will see you next week. Bye bye. Ta-ra.
Bye bye.